Thanks for joining us, Senator. I want to start by asking you about the economy, particularly how it relates to us here in North Carolina. We're in a state that's been hit harder than most by layoffs and jobs shipped overseas, unemployment rate of 7%. So what can you tell the folks here? What concrete measures, what specific steps would you take to get them back working again?
Well, a couple of things. Immediately, I want to give a tax credit to every company that is creating a job in the United States. And we're going to pay for it in part by taking away some of those tax breaks for companies that are shipping jobs overseas. That, I think, is a sensible solution that everybody should be behind. Second thing is to start investing in infrastructure again, our roads, our bridges, but also creating broadband lines that will link up rural areas to the internet, make sure that companies now can locate in some of these communities that have been abandoned. Third thing, energy. We can reopen some of these old textile mills and other factories that have closed down, building solar panels and making sure that we're building wind turbines here in the United States for alternative energy. We can take some of those old tobacco farms and start planting switchgrass to create the cellulosic ethanol, the biofuels of the future. We can create 5 million new energy jobs all across the country, including in North Carolina, which has a great research triangle. But it's going to require the kind of investment from the federal government and leadership from the White House that I want to provide.
Senator, we have a number of industries in this state, particularly agriculture, that rely on immigrants to get the work done. But we have a lot of North Carolinians who are upset that undocumented workers are putting a big strain on the health care system and on social services. So what would you do as president to reconcile that problem?
Well, what we need is a comprehensive immigration approach. We've got to have much tougher border security so that people are not coming in illegally. And I've consistently supported expanding border patrols, surveillance. But most importantly, we've got to crack down on employers who are hiring undocumented workers. They've got to pay serious penalties, serious fines, so that you don't have that lure of a job for poor immigrants who are just trying to feed their families. If we can get those two things in place, then we can also make sure that we are requiring the registry of undocumented workers and require them to pay a fine, learn English. They've broken the law. They should pay their back taxes. They should go to the back of the line, but give them a path to get legal. And when it comes to agricultural jobs, create a system where people are able to hire agricultural workers who genuinely are not replacing U.S. jobs. But all that requires the kind of leadership that we have not seen. Stop making this a political football. Actually solve the problem.
Senator, we talked to some people yesterday here in North Carolina who still have not made up their minds. So if I'm undecided, what can you tell me 2 weeks out now that just might change my mind?
I think the most important thing is just ask yourself, are you better off than you were 4 years ago or 8 years ago? And if you are, you probably should vote for John McCain. If you are, you probably are a very rich person, because those are the main folks who've benefited from these policies over the last 8 years. But for the vast majority of Americans, the average American have seen their wages and their incomes go down over the last 8 years. Their health care premiums have doubled. Their taxes have been a big burden. The cost of everything from food to groceries to gas have gone up. Now, John McCain's not offering anything different than what we've done over the last 8 years. And that means that you can expect more of the same. Even during the debate, I pressed him, tell me one major economic initiative that's significantly different from George Bush's. He couldn't answer. And so what I'm proposing is a new course for our economy, investing in American jobs, investing in new energy approaches, investing in making sure that we've got a health care system that reduces costs for the average family, making sure that we are finally making college affordable for every young person in America. Those are the kinds of initiatives that are really going to build this country long-term and help our families short-term. So I hope that people go out there and vote. Just remember, there's early voting in North Carolina. Mm-hmm. You don't have to wait. You can go and vote right now, and people who need to find out where to go, you can get on a website, www.voteforchange.com, and people will direct you to your polling place where you can cast your ballot right now. I think early voting is going to be a real difference maker in North Carolina.
Final question, Senator. If you're elected, what is your top priority on day one? Is it the economy? Is it the war? Or is it something else?
Well, I think the first thing has to be to make sure that the economy is stable. And that means helping state and local governments deal with higher unemployment rolls, making sure that we're getting a tax cut into families' pockets right away. But I also think it's important to call in the Joint Chiefs of Staff and start figuring out a responsible end to the war in Iraq, refocus our attention on going after Osama bin Laden, and finally, energy. We've got to make sure that we've got the kind of new energy economy that's creating jobs, weaning ourselves off of dependence on foreign oil. That's going to be good for North Carolina.
All right. Thank you, Senator. Appreciate your time today on a very busy day for you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Bye-bye.